Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds, and today I want to quickly run through my newly released seasonal report for summer of 2020. This covers notable bird sightings in Lycoming County, Pennsylvania in June and July 2020. But first I wanted to say a few words on what exactly this report is and what it's used for. So Pennsylvania is somewhat unique in that we have compilers for each county in the state who all do a report that then they're aggregated together into a collection on a seasonal basis. So there's a spring migration, summer or breeding season, fall migration, and the winter season. And all of those are published in a quarterly journal called Pennsylvania Birds that's put out by the Pennsylvania Society for Ornithology, or PSO. And all of the members of PSO receive copies of this journal. So I don't think too many other states are doing that to the county level. There's a lot of other states that will certainly do aggregated notable sightings at the state level. But I don't think there's too many states that are doing to the individual county level. And it's really nice because then you have local experts who are really in tune with the birds of their area doing these reports. So if you want to subscribe to that, basically you just become a PSO member. And I can leave a link in the description if you're interested in that. I think it's $30 a year if I remember correctly. So you can check that out in the description. And I will also leave a link to my the web version of my report, which I always leave on the Lyco Birds website. I don't think too many other compilers are doing that. And I also add a bunch of photos to mine. If you see in the journal, all of the reports are pretty much going to be just text-based. Even mine get compressed down to just text when I send in the version for print. So I'll leave those links in the description. But in any case, I'll jump into just some of the highlights of my report and maybe give a little more backstory to some of the sightings that aren't really appropriate to the format of the report, but you might find interesting. So I'll start with the banner here. This normally in that section I'll put a landscape shot of some sort because that tends to work better in that format. But this ruddy turnstone actually was at Rose Valley Lake right at the beginning of June. It was found the morning of June 1st, and word didn't really get out to the birding community until the late afternoon, and it wasn't until after dinner until I could get up there. But I found it pretty easily in the same spot. And as it turns out, the lighting was absolutely fantastic up there that night, and got some really nice pictures of it. So I like this shot. So I thought it would be fitting for the cover. And this is actually the third county record. There were two previous records, one from Rose Valley that was just a flyby bird that nearly hit me in the face. And then I managed to get some documentation shots as it flew away and never to be seen again. And then there was another one a few weeks after that that showed up at the Williamsport Dam that was a lot more cooperative. So third record is a pretty good one. Overall, the summer was super dry, even as I'm recording this in late August. We still haven't had too much rain. The river's really low, creeks are really low. There were a couple of rain events during the summer, particularly in June, that knocked down a few things, but after that it was very dry. And the total number of species in the county for the summer was 145. That's actually a bit above average. I think normally it's somewhere in the 130s. So that's a bit higher than normal. I don't have any particular reason or any speculation as to why that would be. There weren't too many crazy sightings compared to a normal year, so it's just probably picking up more of the the less common expected things, maybe just more people out birding. In terms of other notable sightings, there was a male lesser scaup, which is pictured here, that spent the entire summer at Rose Valley Lake. That's not too unusual to have some ducks that you don't necessarily think of as summering in Pennsylvania. Rose Valley picks up either a scaup or ringneck duck or redhead or something like that. Almost every summer you can count on something sticking around. So this year was a male lesser scaup. And it was kind of interesting to see the plumage progression as it got further into the summer and he went into more of the eclipse plumage. So I actually did a short article on just a photo comparison over a couple of months. So I'll leave that in the description if you want to check that out. Other notables, a Virginia rail was seen in suitable habitat for breeding at SGL 252, and that was in late June, so that's a good sign that they were probably breeding there. I already talked about the ruddy turnstone pectoral sandpiper near the Muncie boat launch on July 25th. That's a pretty good record. Actually, that's the third one in Lycoming County this year, though, so that's pretty unusual. They're usually harder to find than that. We also had two laughing gulls at Rose Valley Lake on June 10th. A storm, I guess, knocked them down. And that was the second Lycoming County record of that species. And it was the first chaseable record. The first record, which was in May of 2016, my family actually found, and that group of gulls that it was with left very quickly after we found it. So I think we only were on the bird for maybe 2 or 3 minutes. So nobody obviously had any time to chase them. I think some of the county listers were happy to pick up that species for their list. Caspian tern had never been recorded in Lycoming County in the summer before that I know of. And I actually had two of them this summer, one at Mill Street on June 3rd and then Rose Valley Lake on June 27th. So that's interesting. Probably the best record was least bittern at SGL 252. Dan Browning actually found one there in potential breeding habitat on June 3rd. And so he pretty much left them alone for a couple weeks and, you know, decided to do a follow-up survey that I was invited to go on. And we did that on June 25th, and we actually were able to confirm that there was a pair present. And Dan actually found a nest with eggs. And I didn't get to see the nest because we got out of there pretty quickly once we knew it was there. We didn't want to disturb them too much. And as far as I know, nobody followed up after that to see if there were young. We just kind of let them do their thing. So that's a nice breeding record and first county record. Other notables, I had a couple of purple finches up at Rose Valley Lake on June 21st, which is interesting now that I'm sitting here in August, knowing that we are having what looks to be a purple finch eruption starting. They're moving in big numbers up north. So I'm curious if that sighting was related, you know, early migrants pushing through. Of course, that's a species that breeds in the county annually. So, and up in the higher elevations. So they certainly could have been just birds roaming around that were in the area anyway. Also, pine siskin on the 4th of July in Ralston. Pine siskins were extremely scarce last winter, so it's interesting that one showed up in the summer. Hopefully they push south with the purple finches, and red-breasted nuthatches are actually moving south in huge numbers as well. So hopefully we get to see more of them. Another interesting summer record for potential breeding was a white-throated sparrow. I had one at Rose Valley Lake on June 1st, which normally I wouldn't be too excited about that. That could easily just be a late migrant. But I also had one on July 12th, which obviously wouldn't be a migrant. But it's a species that probably nests in Lycoming County every year. They're kind of hard to find. They're not abundant breeders, but certainly at the higher elevations, I would expect to have some of them. So, like I said, if you want to run through the whole report in detail and look at all the photos and stuff, I'll drop a link in the description. And if you wanted to subscribe to the journal, like I said, you just basically join PSO and then you automatically get the journal. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.